This is my constellar deck. I'm updated. I love them so much. It's just a euphoric feeling of having them. I love their artwork a lot. They're just tied to my favorite lords, which is a dual terminal. You know, they're responsible for the Yangzans. They also govern the Gishki, the Gusto, the Gymnite, and the Laval tribes. They also created the Vylons, so they created the Vylons and the Yangzans. Shut down the evil swarms, you know, ended the dual terminal world with Sombre and Xerxion together defeating Sophia. And they also, you know, they kind of, their legacy continues still to this day with the Satilla Knights. So I love them, you know, like, it's just a deck I can't let go. They're my babies. And this is an upgrade on them. So three Sombre, who is just basically, Constellar is short for Star Constellation. And his Star Constellation in the Sombrero Galaxy, if I'm not mistaken. And he's the most pimped out one. His armor is freaking insane. I mean, look at his suit of armor. It looks like almost every Constellar is just on this guy at once. He's just really, really clutch. I love him. Mid to late game, he's very powerful. You hate drawing him early when you can't really use him yet. But he's a lifesaver, and he just, like, he ups your Constellar count, basically, by three more. Because if you get him, you get another one. So it's pretty cool. And he's, you know, one card Pleiady, which is your lifesaver. You can go up to M7 and just prolong your game. He's just really, really good. Like, he's the best Constellar. That's why he's the first one I showed. And, of course, up next, we have the obvious three Constellar Kaos. Kaos is insane, you know, just because he takes away the crippling thing where we can only spam rank 4s, which limits our options. Now we can go to rank 5s or 3s if we choose so. Because he can increase or decrease the level. So he's pretty awesome. Give it up for Kaos. 1800 body, Beast Warrior, searchable by Tinky. He's just really, really good in this deck. A lot of good synergy with him. And of course, three Pollux. Pollux is pretty, pretty awesome. Like, his effect's very difficult to negate. And it's like you can summon him, summon Sombre, use Sombre's effect, exceed, and then summon Algaidi after that, go into Kaos. And then there's so many different ways you can abuse it. You can go Sombre into Algaidi. And, like, just go Algaidi again after you banish an add. Or you can just go Pollux, Algaidi, Sombre. Like, you can just spam the field. It's pretty, pretty awesome. I do love, like, the dual terminal hidden arsenal rarity. A lot of people don't like it. They think it's crappy. But to me, the super rares, you kind of can see, like, a rainbow in them. Like, if you pay attention to Kaos enough, Pollux, you can kind of see, like, a rainbow. So I like these super rares. And I love them so much that I made every card in my deck at minimum a super rare. So the lowest rarity in here is super rare. Screw the commons. They're definitely worth it. These are my babies, so I wanted them to look their best. Double Algaidi. She was at 3 for the longest, and I actually just cut her for more back row. This deck really needs back row to be able to compete with decks. I still feel that Constellars can do or outdo any decks just given, like, the game state. Like, if I just don't have the right monsters, then I can't really do it, but if I can see Sombre and Kaos every game, I can do what I need to do to win. So she was at 3, and eventually I just cut her. Because you can always recycle her if you actually need to use her effect with Sombre. So that's it for monsters. No Honest, no Bears, no whatever other crazy techs people would think of, like Photon Thrasher. It's just the Constellars, and that's it. Double MST, this was at 3. I decided to cut it because my Constellar Omega, there have been times when, you know, one of my Mistys was a waste because I already had Omega on board protecting my Pleiades and Omega at the same time. So I cut it, and, you know, if I need another one, I need another one. But Twin Twisters, I'm not that kind of guy. Twin Twisters, to me, you have to destroy two. So, like, if I set one, you're going to have to set your own just to destroy mine and yours. Which you're negging also because you have to discard a card. It can be shut down by Starlight Road, which is a card it's really coming more and more into my favor because everybody's main decking Twin Twisters. So when people catch on and, you know, just add two and two together, a lot of people are going to start running Starlight Road. And again, like, this deck does not have a lot of good discard fodder. Every card in your hand is so precious. If you discard it, you could really kill yourself. So, Misty's, they work for me. There's certain decks that really could flourish with Twin Twisters, don't get me wrong, but not this deck in particular. And the majority of my decks just don't run Twin Twisters. I'm not that kind of guy. Double Tinky. Tinky also was at 3. But since I'm no longer running Bears, I just cut Tinky down to 2. Just because I need my top decks. Because, like, when I'm in a grind game, and the next card that I draw either makes or breaks my game, I don't want to die from drawing a Tinky that was dead because I already, you know, either drew a counter or searched him. So it's like I only have 3 targets for the 2 tinkies. That works. It works a lot better than 3 tinkies for 3 cows. And of course the Rota. If you get Rota and Tinky, you have Pleiades already. And Pleiades is my star player. It's either him or Durendal that I try to just control the field with. Next up, traps. 3 Grand Horn. Grand Horn will definitely save you. It can negate, you know, if Pendulums do not successfully get summoned, meaning that they never hit the field, they do get sent to the grave. So Grand Horn, that's the main reason why I main it in a lot of my decks, because when Pendulums hit the grave, obviously they can't come back from the extra deck anymore. It's very powerful, and it also steals your opponent's main phase 1, meaning that, you know, it's just too good. Like, it's way too good. It saves your life, like, literally. It saves your life. So, like, if your opponent had could only summon that one monster in his main phase 1, you end that. There, obviously, there's no battle phase, so you could just... It's so good. Like, the fact that it just gets you, like, it protects you from OTKs that can give you another turn, and that one turn can make all the difference. So, Grand Horn is really, really potent. 3 Black Horn. Black Horn is just so freaking good. I love it. I love it. I love it. Black Horn is just like, it's a meta call. It can even hit, you know, Ideas or Eidos, depending on how you summon. If you summon Idea, get Eidos, negate that. And no tribute summon. If you banish Eidos, this special Idea from grave, negate that. And it's just so good. Like, Black Horn's good against every deck. And my personal favorite right now in trap holes is Time Space. Time Space is really, really good, even up against a deck like Monarchs, where, you know, they can summon from their hand, actually. Like, they summon Eidos sometimes from their hand, you can shuffle that back. that's the only thing that really hurts in Monarchs, but every other deck, Cosmos specifically, Cosmos summon from their hand a lot, and sometimes they do go into their extra deck. Of course, BA, and I'm just talking the top 3. In general, Time Space is powerful against a majority of decks. And the top 3, it hurts all 3 of them, you know, so it's just, it's so good. And of course, this is food from our Rafflesia. And next up, a triple breakthrough. Breakthrough is so clutch. I gotta have my breakthroughs, I'm not gonna lie. It's just so good. Like, breakthrough and time space, they're just game changers. They really are. And then double nightmare. Nightmare is just basically more effect negation. Like, it's just really good. It's really, really good. It's a meta call. A lot of monsters, they gotta get their effects off, and more than likely, I'm just gonna say majority, it is when they're summoned. Like, again, going back to the vassals, when you summon Idea Special Eidos, you can negate Eidos' effect, destroy it. Let's see, Dark Destroyer, if Dark Destroyer tries to pop himself or pop another card, you can just negate that, pop him for your opponent. Like, that's just one way you can do it. I wouldn't say that it would necessarily be beneficial to do that to Dark Destroyer, because mainly most people just get him out just to float. But this does definitely, like, it cuts up against the ships. Like, if they pull out Slip Rider and try to pop my back row with Slip Rider, nightmare that, get rid of Slip Rider. You know, as far as BAs, I mean, every time they make Dante, they use his effect. So nightmare is really, really freaking good. Double drowning and double storming. One bottomless, one regular trap pull. You would not believe how clutch this really, really is, especially with Rafflesia. Nobody ever sees it coming. Nobody runs trap pull anymore. And it's just such a good tech. It's won me a lot of games. It's just like a creep up thing. Solemn Warning, Torrential, XYZ Reborn, because it can steal your game. And Vanity's Emptiness. That is 24 traps. It's just like, my constellars now, the way they are, it's either control or control. That's the only way they go. So it's either control with back row or control with monsters. Double M7. M7 at 2 for me, because he recycles my stuff, so I can keep going into my plays. My star player is Pleiades. Pleiades in a full back row is just too hard to play around. Double Omega, one Praesepe, just because he can get over practically anything. Like, he's really, really good. I mean, the highest my constellars can actually reach is 37 with M7 and Praesepe. So that's their max on firepower, because I'm not running Dark Rebellion. Durendal, Volcasaurus, and Tyrus. And my personal favorite, Rafflesia. I have a lot of food for Rafflesia, and I'm definitely going to probably bump this. But for now, it's at 2. I don't want to overdo it. She does have a lot of food. She can eat all day with my deck, but still, I don't want to overdo it, because I still need an aggressive push. Paladynamo and Tsukuyomi, of course. And the side deck, I can't show it. These are my babies, and I take them to certain events. I'm sorry, I can't give out that information.